If you want to create a new AEM app using Adobe's Archetype, or if it's failing to finish, creating too many folders, and perhaps the build is also failing, if you want to avoid some of the typical issues, in this quick tips episode, you will learn how. Keep watching. Hi there, I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co. And in this quick tips series, I will share snackable videos focusing on just one feature or problem. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start. First, let's add Adobe's repository configuration to the settings.xml file, which should be located under your username for your respective operating system. And then inside the .m2 folder, which might be invisible depending on your current configurations. This should help us when we use the archetype and also when building and deploying the new application. You can find in the description below a link to a blog post with all the configurations needed in text format. Before creating the new application, check what version of AEM you currently have and its matching archetype version. For this video, I am using AEM 6.5, which is compatible with most of the latest versions of the archetype. The first thing you need to do for creating the app using the archetype is to open a console or PowerShell session with administrative permissions. This can be accomplished by right-clicking on the command prompt or PowerShell icon, for example, and clicking on Run as Administrator. Inside the admin PowerShell session, use the archetype and provide the parameters like the AEM version, app title, if you want or not a front-end module, and so on. This step is really important if you didn't provide a value of n to the include dispatcher config property explicitly, given that if you used a regular PowerShell session, what you will get is possibly an error using the archetype, and the end result might contain folders that you were not expecting and a project that will not build without making fixes to it. For more information about the available properties, you can go to the Archetype's README page. There, you will find different properties with the values that you can specify and their respective defaults if you don't provide them, like frontend module that specifies by default if you don't want anything to be generated or if you want a regular Node.js module or, for example, one with Reactjs support. If you want the dispatcher configurations to be generated, if you want to include or not the example application code, and many more. After the app has been created, you can change to its directory and use the typical command for building and deploying an AEM application, which you can find in the readme.md. If you forget to change into the directory for the new app, you might encounter the following issue, saying that there is no pom file inside the directory. If you're facing an issue saying that a dependency could not be resolved, failure to find com.djcr.vault, it might be because you are on a machine where the settings.xml file was not changed as described at the beginning of this video. In case you don't want or you can't create the file, you can just add the Adobe public profile into the Maven command to make it work. You might also face an IO exception connection refused message when deploying the application. Sometimes it is as easy as just remembering to start AEM in case you forgot. I have to admit that it has happened to me a few times. Or you might have AEM running using a different port. So in this case, just provide the port using the AEM.port property. Another weird issue that you might encounter is the failed to clean project, failed to delete message. This can happen because you have one of the files inside the target folder open, or sometimes just because the IDE or editor has locked one of those files. If you are unable to make it run after a couple of tries, just close your editors and try again. Once you manage to build the project, you should be able to see the English page inside AEM. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.